Hello everyone. A comfortable workspace is a key to enhance the usability of a software. And one of the nice things about Krita is that it has very good and easily customizable workspace. We already had a brief introduction about the default workspace in the last video. Apart from the default one, there are some other pre-configured workspaces that you can use just to know how things can be arranged in Krita. To change your workspace, just go to the top right corner of the toolbar and click on the workspace button. It will list some workspace presets that Krita provides by default. Choose any one that you like. These presets are created for specific tasks like animation, painting, doing vector works, etc. For now, let's switch back to the default one. Before talking about how to customize the workspaces, I want to let you know about an integral part of Krita's workspace called Dockers. Dockers are these little subsections of the workspace area, like the layer docker, tool option docker, advanced color selector, etc. These can be attached, detached, or collapsed as per your needs. You can open other dockers by going to the settings menu, then docker submenu, and then choosing any one from the list. You can arrange these dockers in any layout easily. Just drag while holding the title bar of the docker and drop it anywhere in the workspace. Krita will show you the shape and the place that the docker is going to take after you drop it. In addition to this, you can resize the dockers too. You can also lock the docker in a place by clicking on this little lock icon in its title bar, so that it is not detached or moved accidentally while painting. These dockers can be arranged as tabs too, by dropping one directly above another. To save some space in your workspace, you can hide the title bar of the docker by going to the settings menu and unchecking Show Docker Title Bars. This will hide the name and buttons for closing, floating, and collapsing the dockers. Now, with these many options to customize, you may end up hiding important dockers, or sometimes end up in a state with dockers all over the place. Don't worry. To reset the workspace to its original arrangement, just select the default workspace from the list in the top right corner that I mentioned in the beginning. Once you have found the ideal workspace which you feel is good for your work, you can save that layout as a preset. To do so, click on the workspace button, add a name, and just click save. Your workspace will be added to the list of presets so that you can use it later. Krita also provides options for the colors of the interface. The default one is dark, and if you like to work in a light workspace, you can change the theme by going to Settings, Theme submenu, and checking Krita Neutral or Krita Bright theme options. In the next video, we will be learning about navigating around a document in Krita.